Welcome, Marina Mello, on my path of experiencing the different terms in the game world of possibility management.
Thank you, Anja.
And we decided to talk about the term liquid state. And I just heard before we started, when we talked, that you seem to have a little cold, I guess, I assume. And one of my assumptions is that this also could be of something that's connected with liquid state. So maybe you want to talk about your own experience with this term, how you live through liquid states, and maybe also for those people who have never heard this term before, just a little theory with it, how you experience the theory.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, thank you. What I have been experiencing, not only from the possibility management, then I could, in the possibility management, I could really get what really is the liquid state. Because before that, I could sense kind of a way, because the liquid states, it's the just this way of reshaping yourself, creating other type of identity about yourself. And because the thing is that we have in the PM, I discovered the box. The box is this main structure that is made of a lot of assumption from the society. For example, you should have a career, you should marry, you should have a daughter, or you should be a mother. And you have all these assumptions, you have all these ideas, and also preference too. So it's kind of the ego. You have this ego that is very rigid. And the more you grow up, the more rigid becomes, because you have more informations coming from outside. And that becomes, your box becomes more rigid to the things that you face in life. And when you start to discover that you have this box and you have all these things that comes from outside that is covering your being, and covering also the access of your bodies, because you have five bodies that are working together in your daily life. You do not have only your mind saying something to you. You also have your physical body. You have your emotional body, so you feel something. But when you have the box acting in your life, you have more like reaction from the things that happen outside. And when you start to be aware of that, then you have some cracks on your box. Like you start to really feel that beliefs that you have been holding in your box is like, oh, it's not mine. And you have these cracks. And this is the start, that's the beginning of the liquid state. When you start to really feel this, all these beliefs, all these assumptions or voices from others, and the path of others start to cracks, and you start to really feel that your shape is changing, like something is changing in you. And many times when you are in this process, in this liquid state, you can also get cold, because your bodies are changing the way, the shapes. So my energetic body, for example, when I'm in the liquid state, I really realize how much I need to rest, like, because my energetic body start to receive informations that my box couldn't and was protecting me to receive it. And so it's the same thing on when you want to have a statue, for example, you want to have a beautiful statue or a deity in your shadow, for example, and you have this golden bar, and to become a beautiful statue, you need to put this golden bar in this liquid process. So you just melt them down, and then you start to, and then you, the more liquid is, the more you can also create shapes. And it's interesting that when you have your box, you're very people can, you have the grip, and people can really you have your gremlin also protecting your box, so you have many parts of you very, very easily to be grip. It's that accurate what I'm saying about the grip?
Yeah,
people can have, because it's very physical, you know, you have it's very material, like you have the reaction and people can really hug you, for example.
Yes, I love that picture you said with the statue in gold. So if I imagine this statue with arms and legs, you can grab it by the arm. But if it's in this liquid state, you cannot get a hold on it.
Yeah, it's like I had also the one once I was holding space for a woman, and she started to, her box was starting to crack, 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 and that's the way that in the PM contest they say about the three phases of healing, because you have in the old map of healing, you have a problem, and it's like you need to remove you from the, yeah, it's like you need to remove the illness from you. And so you go to a therapy, and then I have this problem, I have this illness, I want to remove that from you. In the liquid state, it's the opposite. This is the part of the three phase of healing, that you remove you from the illness. You remove you. You're not rigid. The illness cannot grip on your bodies anymore. And also, I start to remember this movie Dumbo from Disney. That I think that it was Dumbo that was changing shapes, many in colors and shapes, and nobody could see who he was, like, because I think that the liquid state, it's like that. People can see you and cannot really play in this old game of reacting and hooking you, or because you're not anymore in this game, and you and the, yeah, it's like being this adulthood path, it's this ongoing liquid state, so you start to become very it's a normal state.
Yeah, so it sounds like in the beginning, when you start making cracks in your box, it's like one box changes to become another box. And if you go on with those processes, you finally become just the space, and you can decide consciously, which box am I shaping myself in for this minute? And if the next minute needs another kind of shape, I will just reshape to another shape. So it's like I'm like water, and it's hard to imagine because water needs a vessel to be in. But it's like I'm water without a vessel, and I can change shapes as I want to, as I feel good to.
Yes, yes. Yes, and it's your being is deciding. It's not more anymore, because the box is more like the outside is deciding for you the way that you are shaping yourself, and so you are adapting. In this way that you are saying is more like I have my authority back. I have my center with me. I feel all my five bodies and I have the answers from them. And so I, my being in these liquid states can really play in shifting identity, shifting the way that, yeah, and probably we will have a new career. You have a new being. You have a new career. You have a new friends. You have also, maybe you have start to wear new wardrobes. And this is also a way of being liquid, that you are also seeing yourself in many ways, and letting your being really create this possibility to yourself.
Yeah. Yes, thank you. It's a very, for me, it's a very, very clear picture, a very clear possibility. Yeah. And I also, as the way you explained it, I realized that it has served my mental body, my intellectual body, and I feel it's going deeper into the other bodies, the understanding of how you explained that. Thank you.
I'm also Buddhist, and in the Buddhist philosophy, there is this the liquid state is like they call purifying karma, for example, and when you are practicing, you have the moment that you will receive the teaching from, for example, the or from a lama or a guru, and then you have this moment of receiving, and then you receive from your bodies. Then you, when you practice, is the way that you change the shape. And in the PM, you just see the same thing happening, but in more, because you have, the more you heal yourself, the more you also become a healer to others. Because the more you are in this liquid state, you also have your five bodies more receiving from the information that comes from others.
When you say I am also a Buddhist, then there in me is like, well, that's a box, isn't it?
Yeah, it could be something that one of the things that I want to integrate, because I used to be a Buddhist practitioner, yeah. And then I had this gap, and now that I've been in this PM contest, I'm trying to integrate these boxes, maybe. Yeah. And yeah, that's one of the things that I want with my liquid state, to integrate the things that I receive from the Buddhist philosophy, for instance.
Yeah.
And I think that the way that I do is more like really being more liquid and relying on this information that comes from my archetypal body, for example.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for your open-heartedness about that. Thank you. Yeah. Is there anything you have the necessity, you feel the necessity to add about this topic of liquid state? Otherwise, for me, it's round.
Yeah, it's more like many times you're not aware of the things that you have. When you go to an emotional healing process, for example, where the place that you will really feel the liquid state in your bodies, for example, many times you're not aware. You've been trying to figure out the problems that you have in your life from your mind, and you want to solve that using like thoughts and beliefs that is coming from this box, and also from the parent ego state or the assumptions from others. So could also be mixed with the resentence from gremlin, for example. And when you really go to this liquid state in an emotional healing process, you have the access of your consciousness, because you will pick things that you would never see with your mind. And when you really open the space to be aware of that thing that it was hiding from your consciousness, and you have the access from that, wow, it's a doorway, because then many times you go to that door, and then you will probably need to be in this liquid state for a while to really heal that. And not have the grip anymore from that thing that mm-hmm. was holding you back for 30, 40 years of your life, for example.
Yeah.
And you've been trying with your mind to solve that thing.
So it's going away from solving the problem with the problem towards opening up for the space that I haven't known yet, which is around the problems. And it's definitely helpful to have somebody else holding space for that, because it just cannot be done alone.
Yes. Thank you for reminding me that, because when you are alone, you're probably stuck in your mind.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's this beautiful path on PM, that we all have each other, we all offer each other space and accompanying through those states, through those transformations and transitions.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I feel like now, right now, I feel sad and joy at the same time. I feel sad because I see how much the world wants, and also the community wants to gather in an old way, like changing things, changing objects, and really, I saw on the website of PM about liquid state something like, you're listening to the same song. It's the same thing that you put the LP with the scratch, and you put that LP there, and there's the scratch, and you listen to the same song like for 40 years. Yeah. And the way that the community gather in this old way of like, let's change objects, make me so sad, because I see that how much we are losing the opportunity to be intimate, to get the intimacy with others, with people that are in my neighborhood, for example. And in the PM contest, I learned how to really go to the, yeah, to connect to the being and really create intimacy even in small situations in my daily life. Yeah. That could be like insignificant, but it's valid.
Yeah, thank you. I realize we could probably jump from this and go pearl by pearl and have a 1 hour talk. And concerning this topic of liquid state, I think we have covered it very well.
Thank you, Anja.
Thank you, Marina.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Thank you very much.